Indian all-rounder Krunal Pandya has tested positive for COVID-19 in Sri Lanka, forcing the second T20 that was scheduled for today to be postponed by a day. The BCCI has tweeted that the entire contingent is undergoing RT-PCR tests today. India and Sri Lanka are facing off in a three-match T20 series in Colombo, which the visitors lead 1-0. All matches, of course, are already being played behind closed doors at the Premadasa Stadium because of COVID. And earlier, India defeating the host 2-1 in the three-match one-day international series. Rika joining us with the latest on that. Rika, what else are we hearing at this point? When can, in fact, the second T20 be scheduled for tomorrow, as the BCCI seems to think, because there are bound to be several close contacts? Will they all be tested in time? Is there going to be any kind of quarantining or isolation necessary? What are we hearing?
Well, Ankita, a few things here. 8 close contacts of Krunal Pandya have already been isolated. The BCCI has said that the second T20, which was to be played today, will now be played tomorrow, provided the entire squad that has been tested for coronavirus is cleared. The reports are expected to come somewhere between sometime between 6 and 6:30 p.m. today, after which one would know whether the entire team is cleared. If these 8 men are isolated, then perhaps India will have to look for a second line attack. Though we do know that in the last ODI, they had played several newcomers. So it is a jumbo squad that India has in Sri Lanka. They can test several newcomers, but it is really unfortunate. What's really baffling, Ankita, is that Krunal Pandya has been inside a bio bubble in Sri Lanka for over a month, and he's been tested almost every second day. And suddenly, on the morning of the match, when he was tested for COVID-19, he underwent an RT-PCR test that he was found COVID positive. So whether there was a loophole, what really happened, who were his contacts, we still don't know. But as a result, this match has been postponed. The other impact that it'll have is on Surya Kumar Yadav and Prithvi Shaw's travel plans to the UK. They are meant to join the Indian test team in the United Kingdom for the 5 test series that India will play against England. And that fixture starts from the 4th of August.
All right, Rika. Thanks very much indeed for joining us. Cricket commentator and expert Charu Sharma is also with us on the phone line. Charu Sharma, thank you for speaking with NDTV. Your first thoughts on this, the fact that 8 members of the Indian team have been identified as close contacts. Do you believe it's going to be possible to actually have this T20 match played tomorrow, or are we looking at a serious problem here?
Well, I hope we're not looking at a serious problem. I mean, it's the eternal mystery of this pandemic continues about how it sneaks in and out from all sorts of places. I'm not prepared to believe that Krunal Pandya was the only one who did something that was not permitted, because I think all the boys now are, well, all teams, all sporting teams are only well aware that instead of going around to places which are banned, they should really, you know, tighten up their schedule to make sure that they are not transgressing anywhere. About the match, yeah, I and why only 8? I suppose it could be every member of the team.
Right. Well, everyone's undergoing RT-PCR tests right now, so clearly no chances are being taken.
Well, everyone is, and they're getting the results fairly quick. So on one hand, of course, you feel particularly sorry for Krunal Pandya.
Right.
Because, I mean, who wants to be the center of this kind of attention? And then, you know, also the potential, God forbid, guilt of perhaps passing it on to others who may now be tested, you know, although everyone is. So, I mean, only his test has come positive, or so be here. I don't know. And, you know,
yes,
in
indeed.
A hotel in Sri Lanka.
Charu Sharma, on that larger point that you're making about bio bubbles and about COVID appropriate behavior, in the past, two bio bubbles have seemed to be fairly ineffective when it comes to actual outbreaks like this. Do you think then that rules and protocols need to be perhaps strengthened, or, you know, how does one then have sports tournaments at all while there is a pandemic?
I know that's a sticky question, but I think it's already tight enough. I don't think, you know, you wish to expect sportspersons to perform from a sort of a jail-like penitentiary condition. You know, there has to be some team bonding. There has to be some kind of normalcy that is accorded to teams once they've all been cleared of COVID at certain points. And of course, everyone's getting tested all the time anyway. It can otherwise be very annoying, very cloying, you know, a deeper sense of being quarantined.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, these are rare instances. I mean, at the Olympics, you hear people getting COVID all the time. And I'm sure that in Japan, which is a very sort of fastidious country, surely all possible efforts are being taken to make sure that people, you know, don't contact this. But and there are cases.
And yet we have over 150 cases in the Olympic Village alone. So clearly something is going wrong.
Well, exactly. So, yeah. So, you know, I mean, obviously this pandemic is stickier, like a bit of a limpet, you know, than we know. And all I can, you know, you have to see the positive side.
All right.
You know, I mean, there is testing, there is isolation, and the event carries on. Now, some may say, what's the need for the sporting event to carry on? Well, because it also provides a lot of joy. It also rewards a lot of the hard work that's gone on.
Mm-hmm.
And if people consider themselves safe, and if they say, well, we've done all that was required of us in terms of quarantining and bubbles and everything else, then we must be allowed to carry on our trade. Because, you know, in any city, if there are a few cases, I mean, our cities are not completely locked down either, right? And there are COVID cases around still, say, in India. Now, what if all of India was still stuck at home, completely isolated from everywhere else because there were some cases around? So it's a vexing problem, no doubt. And I would once again like to say that the Indian team management, the Sri Lankan board as hosts, will do everything possible to make sure that if anything can be tightened, they will.
All right. Charu Sharma, thanks very much indeed for joining us with your thoughts.